one. Fight.
Oh, okay. You're just gonna roll at me like that? That's not even safe. And now you're gonna slide at me like that? That's not safe either. Okay, so we've got a YOLO Vega here. That's supposed to be punishable. Okay. Okay, okay. YOLO Vega, YOLO Vega. Diffused a little bit here. I like it. Oh, dude, I had a Vega laugh there. Is that okay, maybe I don't know. You actually, you know what it is? The block stun on it is so much shorter than I remember. That's always the problem. Oh, okay, good stuff. He actually baited an uppercut. Ow. Dude, this Vega's nuts! Holy crap! I whiff a button in the sweep! I whiff a button in the sweep! I whiff a button in the sweep! Alright, alright, alright. I need to figure out why I don't dive kick properly. Whoops, I just missed with my jump attack. That's strange. Where's my EX uppercut? Look at this YOLO bait, dude. Okay, okay. Whoa, he recovered fast from that. I didn't know he recovered from the whiff. From the whiff rose that fast. Okay, okay, okay. Interesting. I did not know that. I did not know that. I have lost all my points. I have lost all my points. You know what the hardest thing about the one and done players for me are? Is that when I do better in 2 out of 3 sets than I do against one person, then I do. Oh my god, I walked too far forward. Oh, that was nice. Text from this Vega. Honestly? Oh god. Okay, honestly, this Vega has some really weird timings and button choices, and it is throwing me off a lot. I cannot read this Vega player at all. Look at this double roll. That's a thing. And meaty? That's interesting. Wake up throw text. Oops. This is a crazy, crazy Vega player. He's got some really good button timings, though. He's got some good button timing and some very interesting button choices. See? It's really interesting how this Vega chooses to play. Hmm. Gotta fix this problem of mine. I have this really terrible problem where I cannot dive kick. Wow! Okay, okay. Roll is not safe. EX roll is safe. Regular roll should not be safe. Should never be safe. Should never, ever, ever, ever be safe. They didn't make it safe. It's punishable. It's punishable. It's just the interesting part about it is that the roll is... the block stun on the roll is really short. The block stun. You have to attack way faster than you think. See? Whoops, too far. Why would I uppercut in that situation? That's odd. That's odd. Why would I uppercut in that situation? There's no reason to hit for him to hit a button in that situation, so that uppercut was completely uncalled for. Round So he was throwing a lot on his wake up. So what I would actually, he's doing delayed throws. So I was just delaying my meaty ever so slightly to get him to open himself up. Whoops. Oh, interesting. Okay. Oh, that's a thing. Oh, didn't realize it's a thing. Now you're scared. Oops. Now I'm dead. Ah, crap. All right. Yeah, very unfortunate situation there. Just got caught by a lot of setups that I wasn't aware of that Vega could do, like command throw into command throw on quick rise. So. Unfortunately, once again, I've started this and I've been slowly losing points again, but we'll see if I can get myself back to the points. Yeah, and no anti-air, of course. That's just a standard problem of mine. And it's so bad that sometimes I don't even notice when I don't anti-air. Like, I totally didn't even realize that I wasn't anti-airing that match, but yeah, you're right, I wasn't anti-airing. And so that just causes me so many problems. It gives the opponent always a free mix-up. Every time you block a jump-in, you give the opponent a free mix-up. This is not really teaching me much here, because I know he's gonna kick. I know he's gonna do something eventually, so I can just react to something being pressed and then I can hit a button. So as soon as I see something happen, I can hit a button. But what I need to do then is also record. Right, exactly. That's the thing, is I want to put intervals in there. That's exactly what I want to do. Like, do, actually, what I want to do, intervals, start recording automatic. There we go. And then for this one, I just want to do, actually, this. So as fake movement. Put this all on here, put it onto all block. Oh no, you can't do all block because you're doing playback recording here. So what I should do then is, okay, this is what I should do. No, that's fine. Wow, that one plays a lot. See, that's the thing that I'm worried about with Irian, is if you do sit there and try to whiff punish him all day, you open yourself up for getting counter whiff punished by an EX shoulder charge, and then if he has a V-trigger, you die. I really need to watch a match where Cammy actually outfootsies Irian to find out if it's something that is achievable by me, or if it is something that is just because my reactions are so bad that maybe that's why I can't do it. Okay, very buttonsy Chun-Li. Lots of buttons. See if I can get him with the okie doke. What's Cammy's best matchup? That's a really good question, actually. I'm not sure. Interesting neutral jump timing. Interesting neutral jump timing there, but then she's hitting a lot of buttons on wake ups, and that's what's getting her killed, unfortunately. Yeah, that's probably true too. That is definitely true. I'm just not sure how to whiff. I mean, honestly, my whiff punishing is really bad. I don't whiff punish anybody. So that's just something I have to add into my game somehow. And I have to figure out how to do that. I just need to figure out how to become a better whiff punisher. Buttons each other. He likes to hit a lot of buttons. Ooh, okay. Interesting. Should have confirmed that. See, lots of buttons in the middle there, so I have to frame trap faster is what I'm doing wrong. I'm not frame trapping fast enough. Oh wow, she's just hitting buttons right away. Okay. Okay, I need to do standing fierce. Standing fierce will work there. Oh, I just ran out. That was unfortunate. Oh, I tried to anti-air with jab. Why? Why would I try to anti-air with light punch? Why would I anti-air with light punch? Oh man, back medium punch. So I have the reaction to try to anti-air just with the wrong button. And that got me killed there. Okay, okay. Very button intensive Chun-Li after two pokes. She likes to do one poke and then she'll block two. So actually I should go in after one is what I should do. See, like she's very counter pokey. Wow, interesting. Dash up low. She's lightning kick? Crouching Fierce is such a weird button to hit in that situation, but it's working for her, unfortunately for me, and I need to just be better about that. Oh my god, I'm so terrible. Oh my god, really? Oh, what the hell, really? Oh my god. Now all of a sudden she's scared. Whoa, really? That was the most fantastic read I've ever seen, and I will give that to her. I will give that to her that she woke up with jump air throw on me. Holy shit. I am definitely down with that. I am definitely okay with that reaction. Oh boy. All the way back down to 6,000 again. Man, I get into these slumps all of a sudden. Like, I feel like what I should be doing is playing 2 hours and then stopping. And then playing 2 hours and stopping. And then playing 2 hours and stopping. I think I just get to the point where my brain starts getting fuzzy and I start playing on autopilot. And then it gets to the point where I stop actually trying to play properly. And I'm not analyzing things anymore. Like, I actually just get tired, and you get to that point where you start autopiloting everything. Because, like, if you notice, this is the same pattern that I go through every single time I do these sessions. I start off by winning a bunch of my first matches, and I get a bunch of points. Then I lose all the points, and then I have to try to get the points back. Oops, I didn't mean to connect. Oh, I didn't do that. Didn't even mean to pick that fight. That fight was a four-bar match. Yeah, it's hard. That's one of the hardest things about playing for long periods of time. It's really hard to stay consistent because even though you don't realize it's happening, you get tired. You actually get tired from playing for long periods of a time. This is a France connection. No wonder it was four bar. And I have to fight against a Laura on a four bar connection. Oh man, this is not gonna be good. This is not gonna be good.
Round one.
Let the teleportation begin. Yeah, baby. Thank you. really do have to learn how to use the hooligan dive kick more. Oh, too far. Too far. I tried to burst, did I? I actually tried to burst. It was so weird. I've been playing too much Guilty Gear. I thought they fixed that! You're going for a mix-up. I'm just gonna EX uppercut you. Final round. Huh. That's an interesting. That's like an automatic frame trap. She did the back roll and I timed my meaty incorrectly, so that's my fault. That's my fault. Yeah, it's interesting because as I keep streaming too, you notice that I talk less during the matches and everything like that. I really do feel like my brain just kind of disappears out into this like zone where like all of a sudden I just don't think anymore and I stop paying attention and I stop analyzing anything. It's a problem. It's definitely a problem. Something that I need to figure out how to fix. It's just fatigue. Maybe it's because I haven't eaten all day. I'm not sure. Ooh, that was crazy. Nice. That block on that dash under was really nice. Oh no. Okay. Ugh. Ugh. Okay. Yep, here we go. This is the middle part of the show that everybody is familiar with, where James loses all of his points and he has to figure out how to readjust his brain so that he can actually start playing again. It's really interesting. It's really interesting. It's actually pretty telling how much just like continuing to play like this really does just make you tired. Gotta figure out how to keep yourself. And honestly, like, what's interesting about this is the reason why I keep doing this, and everyone's like, go ahead and take a break. But I mean, this also is something that's key to do during tournaments as well. It's very easy to get tired and autopilot your way through tournaments as well. Jesus! This is genius! So funny. So funny. This is actually pretty entertaining. I have to focus so much on this. Holy crap. Footsie machine, dude. It's like footsie's on command, dude. That's so funny. No, I'm not gonna enter any events, Haza. It's not where I'm meant to be at this point in time. My skill level is far too deteriorated these days. I don't get to play enough, and when I enter events and I lose, I just get angry. And it affects my ability to commentate and stuff like that. I probably won't enter anything. I definitely think my time is past. Let's just put it that way. I don't think it's in the cards for me anymore. It's just old and just not being able to stay sharp in the game, unfortunately. Cats are upstairs. I need to learn how to stream downstairs, upstairs, so that I can actually have the cats around. But they can't be in the studio area, because the studio area has too many wires and too much cables and all sorts of craziness. Like, if I actually showed you what the studio area looked like from the view that you can't see, like, it's super messy over here. That was weird. Quick riser. Yeah, you cannot wake up armor. You cannot wake up armor in that situation. I went 0-2 at Anime Ascension. I went 0-2, but that was just more lack of character knowledge. What the hell? Wake up, Comanthro! Oh my god, that was genius. You are a genius. Best out of all of us, I would say. He's still a young man, so he still has all the reactions in place. Huh. Ooh, you are a buttonsy Mika. Ooh, how did I not? Okay, good stuff. Good stuff, good stuff. So yeah, I'm playing really bad here. Okay, very buttonsy Mika, very buttonsy Mika. So I have to play more patient, I have to play calmer, and I have to frame trap a little bit better. So, David's problem right now is he actually has a physical problem, is that he actually has something that prevents his hands from doing what he wants it to do. So it's tough in that situation. Jesus! You are hitting crouching light kick every single time when you get up. Wow, that was amazing. I appreciate that one. Oh man, I'm playing so terrible against this Mika. It's also because I'm not anti-airing the jumps again. Round two. Fight. Do you see what I mean by this? Mika always wakes up with a crouching light kick. It's so crazy. In every situation, she pokes with a crouching light kick. Oh, that was far. Holy crap. Okay, this Mika did a really good job mixing between the ground and the air. Whoa, how did she get into the air? How did she get into the air? Wingless airplane is not airborne on the first frame, is it? Is it? It's not Parkinson's. I don't remember what it's called. But basically what happens is that when his brain sends a message to his hands, it doesn't actually get there. So, or it's just misinterpreted. So he'll be like, okay, do standing medium kick, and all of a sudden he'll do crouching fierce. Like, his hands will just do the wrong thing. It's really, really strange. that it happens to him that way. So otherwise, he'd be pretty good as well. So yeah, I mean, here we go. This is at the point right now where I have, I got to like, I was at like 6,800 at some point, and I just dropped all of my matches here in the middle again. Every time I edit these episodes, I feel like I say the same things. Like every time I watch these back and I edit them, it's always the middle. Like every description I always give with every video is like, James starts out strong, but then all of a sudden he hits a slump. Like every single time. And this is why I don't enter tournaments anymore, because I just feel like I'm just at this point right now where I can't concentrate long enough, and I just don't feel like my skill level is high enough anymore. And it's frustrating. I wish I could fix that. I wish I could figure out why it is, but I'm not sure if it is an age thing or if it just is that it's just hard for me to stay mentally focused or something like that. And now they're sending me weaker and weaker players. Like, okay, fine. Here's a 3,800 point player now to help you get your points back up.
Round one. Fight.
Jabbing. Oops. Huh. How did that not punish? That's weird. I guess the thing is not -3. Okay. I thought it was more negative than that. I did not do that all day. What would make you think I was going for a meaty throw like that? That's so weird. That's so bizarre to me in those situations like that. But I think it's just I'm probably not doing something enough to hide the throw again. If I juked, I probably would have gotten that throw. I really gotta figure out why that happens. How is that too far? That's crazy. Dashed up and did nothing. Yeah. I tried a super. What the hell? What the hell was that?
You win.
Yeah, it does. It does hurt. But I mean, like when I was commentating early on, I was actually winning, which is weird. But like the thing about it is, when you commentate your own matches while you're playing and then you're focusing really hard, like. I don't feel like when I stop talking, it's because like I'm getting into the matches. I think the reason why I stop talking a lot is because I think I just get fatigued. I think I just get tired, and I just stop focusing. Like I felt myself zoning out during that match against that Zangief. Like I literally felt myself like I just stopped thinking, like I just wasn't trying anything anymore. And I need to, this is like an external thing, right? This is just something that I need to figure out myself on how to make sure that I don't get into this mode all the time where all of a sudden I just start losing focus and I'm sleepy or I'm like tired and I zone out. But, you know, it's interesting too because a lot of what happens in fighting games is outside of fighting games as well. So it's actually kind of a neat thing to understand too, to grasp for yourself why these kind of things happen to yourself, you know? So it's actually kind of good to know. The reason why I get angrier when I lose in this game than in Guilty Gear is because I know I'm terrible in Guilty Gear. I have no expectations of winning. But in this game, I feel like I should have an expectation of winning. And then also when I lose, it's because I'm not uppercutting jumps and stuff like that. Even though I've told myself to uppercut jumps for like 3 months now. Well, honestly, I've been telling myself to uppercut jumps for 20 years, and I have problems with that for some strange reason, so. Yeah, no, that Zangief never went for an SPD. It was really interesting. It's very interesting. It's like he was always scared to go for that mix-up.
Round one. Fight.
Huh. Establish the throw early on. Don't give the Bison the opportunity to go nuts with that dash. Just don't give him the opportunity. Just jab a lot. Just jab a lot. I meant to dive kick and it came out with a jumping medium kick. My missed dive kick actually saved me. No, Supreme 11, Hooligan dive kick is better. They buffed the Hooligan dive kick. It's much better than it used to be. So that's actually something that's really important to note. That's why I'm trying to integrate it into my game a little bit more. So, because it's something that's very, very useful. Oops. Oh, that was a cross-up? Establish the throw, then establish the shimmy. Establish the throw, then establish the shimmy.
Round two.
Too far. Oh, mutual jump. Neutral jump in response to my jump. No anti-air. What am I doing? Jesus Christ, James. See, my reaction to the jump was just to keep walking. Keep walking until death, basically. Oh, he threw? I tried to empty jump. I tried to empty jump that. He throw. So empty jump low, the way to beat that is through throwing. So it's interesting that two people that I've tried to do empty jumps on, they've thrown. Oh my god, my jumping roundhouse won? Nice, I like that. Sorry, I tried to drill in the super and I missed that. I need to get that. Okay. Well, I did decently against a bison. I'm glad I beat a bison who has more points than me. And I was getting blown up a lot by bisons before, so I played that one a lot smarter, so that felt really good. Yeah, the dash, you notice that basically I'm just looking for it. I mean, the unfortunate thing about that dash is there is still a lot of startup to it. And because there is a lot of startup to it, you can punish it. The stronger bisons will mask it more with fake movement and stuff like that, as opposed to just trying to dash. But when you see him activate V-trigger, the key thing is that you have to remember that his V-trigger is active. The one thing that bisons can do the best once they activate V-trigger is not make it obvious that they have it. Like, just kind of like play normally, poke with kicks and all of a sudden, and then all of a sudden dash out of nowhere and get it. Because their best strength once they activate V-trigger is to make you forget that they've activated V-trigger. Oops. I gotta practice that. Have to be fast. There's got to be a more reliable way to do that. Yeah, that's the better way to do it. Maybe that's not the more reliable way to do it. Just something that I have to be ready to try to do, because there are a lot of times where I could win matches, but I just end up doing the combo because I'm not used to doing this in the super. I'm just not used to it. The other thing I should probably learn is, see, that one for some reason has always been harder for me. That one right there, that one's always been harder for me. Maybe that's what I should just do. Maybe I should just learn to just cancel it. No, well, maybe. I'll see. Yeah, Bison, you never know when to press buttons against Bison. It really is about... you have to understand that Bison can't move, that he can't walk. It's really hard for Bison to control the distance. So when he creates, when he activates V-Trigger, even outside of V-Trigger, Teleport Dash is what he's going to want to do the most. It's just what he feels like he needs to do in order to get the position. So if you can play in a way that really upsets the Bison's distance and footsies, that kind of increases their temptation to want to dash. And then you can actually, what do I think of DiCapre? I really didn't like the way DiCapre turned out in Street Fighter V. Looks-wise. I think design-wise, motion-wise and stuff, she was kind of neat. But I feel like there was definitely a lot more they could have did with her looks-wise than how she looked. Oh my god! A jumping Ryu, and now you are starting to teleport. I almost had that. I made that mistake. I said I was gonna stop doing that. Throw Tex into EX dive kick, and I did it again. Reaction. Interesting reaction. Yeah, well, she's negative on most standard dive kick. She's on EX dive kick is -2 now. That was one of the nerfs in this version. That was one of the nerfs in Street Fighter in Season 2. Huh. I didn't mean to do a quick rise. Interesting reaction to a throw tech. Let's just go right into a super. Okay. Yeah, she used to be positive on those EX dive kicks, which is why they were so good, but now they're not anymore. So in Season 2, they changed it, and it's still something that I rely on too much, that I have to stop trying to do too much, so...
Round one. Fight.
Oh wow, that's cool. Ouch, he hit my... Where's my EX? Oh, I didn't even have an EX. I was looking at the wrong meter. Yay, okay. That's how Cammy's supposed to win. It's just overwhelming like that. Oh, man. Gotta remember my advice. Stop using that move. Oof. Oh, dang. Okay, I was not expecting that. I dropped my combo. Oh man. Yeah, this is definitely not going well at this point in time. I definitely am fatigued a little bit, but I just don't want to lose this low in points now. I don't want to quit this low in points. I want to try to get my points back. Oh man. I gotta try to get my points back, but I don't know if this is actually a really good idea at this point in time. Like, I really should honestly be taking a break, but oh man, this happens to me every time. At 6 o'clock, I'm always down at points. I start at 3 p.m. At 6 p.m., I'm always really down in points, and then I have to figure out a way to make that comeback, to like get all my points back every single time. Oh. But yeah, one of the reasons why I'm salty about this is because honestly, I shouldn't be doing this bad. It shouldn't be this hard for me to play. Like, I'm playing really badly at this point in time. And it really does make me sad that when I play this badly like this, like, I know I'm better than this at Street Fighter. And it's hard when you play like this, and then when outside things kind of cause these problems and you start playing badly. And you start making mistakes like this. But this is the gambling addiction, right? This is what happens to everyone with the gambling. People lose, like, they go up a little bit, then they start losing and they feel bad because they were up so high, and then they keep trying to make the comeback, and then it just goes back and forth like that all the time. Just gotta play smarter. Just gotta get my brain in the game right now. Like, I feel it. I can feel my brain dropping out of the match where it just like zones out and you're not thinking anymore. Like those first few matches that I play, I'm always thinking so hard, and I win those matches, and then all of a sudden it goes bad like this. That's such a weird reaction to jumps. Yeah. The autopilot is one of the scariest things that actually happens. Ooh. So if the opponent's not willing to stop the hooligan dive can be really, really useful like that, because after you saw, after she blocked the hooligan dive, I crouching light punch and I won, because the hooligan dive kick is actually positive on block in a lot of situations, so. This guy wants some revenge against... Revenge against Camino, I'm sure. Oops. Nice, made that save. Made that save. Oh yeah, of course he's gonna throw there. Use the cross up button too. Use the cross up button. Good stuff. Good stuff. Round two. Wow, nice. You cannot escape! Didn't kill. That was unfortunate. He just dropped his combo now. Oh, that's safe, that's right, I forgot. Oh, I was not expecting that. I forgot that move existed. Interesting, interesting, okay. Okay, so the jury actually got a chance to play this time, so she had a few tricks, but really right now my biggest problem is I'm not watching my legs. I noticed that in a couple of other matches this happened too, that a Chun-Li would dash up and just catch me, would just dash up crouching medium kick into lightning legs. And I'm not crouching enough. I'm not keeping my legs honest. And so I'm getting hit a lot by dash up crouching moves. Okay, good throw. Good neutral drop. Nice. Okay, he's definitely detected that I'm weak to throws. What? He did crouching medium punch right there? That was crazy. Oh, nice. Again, using that cross up medium kick on the way down. I hit standing medium punch and... nothing came out. Nothing came out. Oh god, those neutral jumps are so beautiful. I swear. Oh, nice. Oh, God, I'm hitting buttons on my wake up. Oh, my God. All right, okay. There's definitely something wrong with the way my brain is playing right now. Like, you can tell, like, I'm falling asleep on these matches all of a sudden. Like, I'm not thinking anymore.